everyone. I hope you're ready for some fun. Let's stand up and get started. Here we go. Welcome, welcome, everyone. Now you're here, we'll have some fun. With our hands, we clap, clap, clap. With our feet, we stamp, stamp, stamp. Welcome, welcome, everyone. Now you're here, we'll have some fun. Now we're learning some new songs today, and this first one is called Insects on Me. Here we go. A fly is on my face. A fly is on my face. Hi, ho, watch me go. A fly is on my face. And how about a gnat is on my nose. A gnat is on my nose. Hi, ho, and watch me go. A gnat is on my nose. A hornet is on my head. A hornet is on my head. Hi, ho, and watch me go. A hornet is on my head. And we're going to do one more. We've got a bee on my back. Here we go. A bee is on my back. A bee is on my back. Hi, ho, and watch me go. A bee is on my back. Great job. Now let's see. How about take your hand and make a fist out of it. Here's a beehive. Where are the bees? Hiding away where nobody sees. Soon they come creeping out of the hive. One, two, three, four, five. Bzzz. Good job. Now let's see. How about the bugs? This is called The Bugs Go. Now let's see what kind of bugs we're going to be singing about. Here we go. The fireflies in the sky go blink, 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 blink. The fireflies in the sky go blink, blink, blink all night long. The crickets in the grass go chirp, 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 chirp. The crickets in the grass go chirp, chirp, chirp all day long. The bees in the hive go buzz, 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 buzz. The bees in the hive go buzz, buzz, buzz all day long. Let's do some butterflies now. The butterflies in the sky go flutter, 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 flutter. The butterflies in the sky go flutter, flutter, flutter all day long. The grasshoppers in the grass go hop, 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 hop. Grasshoppers in the grass go hop, hop, hop all day long. The ants on the ground go march, 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 march. The ants in the grass go march, march, march all day long. Wonderful job. Now I've got the flannel board today, but this, we're not hiding anything under this. This one is about a little turtle. So I have a little turtle there. And then I have some other things too. I have this at the end is supposed to be a person or a me, this little end there, me. So we have a mosquito, a flea, a minnow, which is a kind of a fish, and me. So here we go. I had a little turtle. He lived in a box. He swam in the puddles and he climbed on the rocks. He snapped at a mosquito, he snapped at a flea, he snapped at a minnow, and he snapped at me. He caught the mosquito, he caught the flea, he caught the minnow, but he didn't catch me. We're going to do it one more time. This time I'm going to put my flannel board down, and we're going to kind of act it out. All right, so you just do what I do. Here we go. I had a little turtle. He lived in a box. He swam in the puddles, and he climbed on the rocks. He snapped at a mosquito. He snapped at a flea. He snapped at a minnow, and he snapped at me. He caught the mosquito. He caught the flea. He caught the minnow, but he didn't catch me. All right, everyone, keep watching. You'll see the crafts that we're going to make today and some yummy snacks, too. Our theme today is insects. Now, there are at least 1 million different kinds of insects in the world. Now, a scientist who studies insects is called an entomologist. Now, all insects have six legs, and many of them have wings at some point in their lives. And some insects have such amazing eyesight that they can see colors that people can't see. And other insects eat and eat and eat when they're young, but when they're older, they don't eat anything at all. Now, insects live everywhere. They live in the air around us. They live in the ground under our feet. They live on plants and trees, and they even live in the water. So today, we're going to do some crafts about insects. And the first one that we're going to do is a windsock. Now, this would make a wonderful decoration that you could hang in your house, or you could hang it outside, somewhere though where it won't get wet, because we're only using paper. So if the paper gets wet, it will not last very long outside. So we are going to do a bee today. So the first thing, I'm starting with a yellow piece of paper, and I've got some black strips of paper, and I've got some yellow, this is tissue paper, but you could use tissue paper or crepe paper. So we're going to start using our streamers here, and I'm going to glue about six on, and I'm going to start about a third of the way down. I'm going to see how quick I can get these on. All right, so we're going to use our glue stick, and we're going to get, there's one, and here's two, and we'll get number three on, and four, open this one up, and we're going to put one more on, so we put five on. Then after we have our streamers on, I'm going to turn it over, and we're going to put some stripes on our bee. And we're going to leave enough space at the top so we can put some eyes and a mouth on. So I'm going to just glue three stripes down here. And we've got one. And we'll get two more. So we've got one, and here's two, and one last one, and three. Now we need to put a face on. So I have got some googly eyes. If you don't have any googly eyes, you could always use white circles and color in some black for the eyes. So we're going to try and put these in about the middle here. And you can use a glue stick, because I've used a glue stick for the googly eyes. You just have to use a lot. I'll stick that on. And I'm going to take a black marker, put a smile on. Put a little smile like this. And then we're going to put some antenna on. And I cut a pipe cleaner in half. And I'm going to kind of twirl it around my finger like this. Kind of make it like a curly Q. I'm going to turn our bee over again, our paper over again. And we are going to tape our antenna on. And there we've got one. Get the other one on. I just have to make sure I'm getting it in the right spot. Other one. Then we are going to roll it. And you could glue it, but I'm going to tape it because I just think it works easier sometimes to tape. So let's see if I can get this. I'm going to tape it up near the top. I'm going to try and make sure that it's even. And once you get that first piece of tape, it is easier. Put one more piece of tape on the bottom here. All right, got our B. And now one more thing that we're going to put on. We're going to put on a handle. So we've got one more black strip. And we're going to put one this side. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the tape on it, like this, and stick it inside our two. Fold it over. And get one more piece of tape on. And there is our B windsock. I'm going to put that over here for now. Now, we're going to do a butterfly. And for our butterfly, we're going to use our handprint. So I've already traced my hand on a piece of paper. What I did was I folded a piece of paper in half, and I took my hand, and I put it, so my palm is a little bit off the paper there. And I'm going to cut it out. And since I folded the paper, I'm going to have two handprints. So just cut it out carefully. And some of you might need a little help doing that. And that's okay. It's nice to have help with projects. And you could do it any color you want. I am doing one of my favorite colors, which is yellow. All cut out here. And then you're going to open it up. And these are going to be our butterfly wings. We're going to take a craft stick and we're going to glue some pom-poms on. And I have four pom-poms. And you're going to want to leave the bottom without pom-poms because this is how you're going to hold it. So I'm going to take some glue. Oh, I've got one already opened. And you're going to start with a pom-pom that's a little bit bigger. All right, so that's going to be the head. So I'm going to put this pom-pom right at the very top of my craft stick. Then I'm going to put glue. And again, I'm using a glue stick, and the glue stick does work. If you have tacky glue or a different kind of glue at home, a liquid glue, that will work too. Sometimes that's easier. All right, I'm going to put on four smaller pom-poms. They're a little bit smaller. I'm going to need a little bit more glue right here. And put that on there. And we're going to use some googly eyes for our butterfly. And let's see where I put them. I think I've got some right in here. And if you don't have googly eyes, you can use little white circles. I just happen to have googly eyes. Oh, and you know what? I'm going to show you something else in 1 second. Because I realized I forgot to do something to our bee. All right, now we're going to put a little glue on our googly eye and stick that on. There we go. Except it likes to stick on my finger. A little bit more glue on this one here. And there we go. Put that on there. All right, and we are going to now, I have a pipe cleaner and I cut about 4 inches for this. And you can glue it. You might want to just bend the antenna down a little bit. I'm going to put some glue, a lot of glue on this, and stick it onto our craft stick. All right. There's that. And we are going to take our butterfly wings. And you could, if you would like, you could draw a little design. You might put a little few little dots on. And I'm just going to put a few. Do it any way you want. You could use any colors you want. I'm just putting a few on here. You're going to put glue right down the center where the fold is. And you're going to take your craft stick that have your pom-poms on and going to stick this right on it. And you now have a butterfly. And I had done one a little earlier because I wanted to make sure it was dry so I could show you. But the wings will flutter for you a little bit. And there is a butterfly. All right, so I'm gonna move this one out of the way. Now, I realize our bee is missing something. Do you know what our bee is missing? Wings. And I do have wings that I had cut out here. So we're going to just tape them on here so you'll see. I don't know how I forgot to put the wings on our bee. Right? There's one. And two. All right, we've got our bee, a little bit more tape on this. All right, so we have our butterfly, we have our bee, and we are going to do actually another caterpillar to butterfly. And this is very easy. We're going to take a... this is an empty toilet paper roll. You could use any kind of an empty roll. If you're going to use a paper towel roll, just have to cut it a little bit. And you don't have to, but I wanted to cover mine in white paper. So I'm just going to wrap this around it. Like this. And this will be the cocoon. And then we need a clothespin, and you're going to make the head will be the part that opens. And you're going to take some pom-poms again, and we're going to put a lot of glue. Alright, so I am using, you could use different colors, they're all the same. I am using all blue for this. Here, and then I want to show you how I did the wings. All right, so there we go. And we're going to put on some eyes. And we have two googly eyes for our caterpillar. Make the wings, I wanted to do a little special. So I have a, if I can get that to stick on. Sometimes the eyes like to stick on me instead of on my pom-pom. Let's see. I'm gonna let this dry for a little bit. If it doesn't work, I have one that I was able to make a little earlier today. So we may just set that aside, but I'm gonna show you how. I do have these eyes sticking right on me. I'm going to stick that like that. And we got a pom-pom there. I'm going to let that dry. Now, to make the wings, I took a coffee filter and some washable markers, and I just made some color around. And you could do a pattern if you want, but you don't have to. So I'm using just a little purple, and I'll use a little red. And what other color? And I'll use a little, maybe green. I'll put a little green, a green on the bottom, in the middle. So I just put some color on the filter. Now I'm gonna fold it in half. And I'm going to fold it in half again. And one more time. Fold it like this. Actually, I'm going to do it again. So I have just a real little piece, real little triangle. And I have a cup of water. And I'm just going to stick this in, hold it in for a minute, and the water is going to be absorbed by the coffee filter, and you'll see what's going to happen to those colors. Just leave it in there for a minute, and the water is going up, 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 up. All right. And I'm going to take this out. I'm going to open up another one that I did earlier today for you. Okay, just drip a little bit. But this is one that I did earlier today, and see how all the colors blended? So we are going to then take the coffee filter. We are going to open up the clothespin and stick the wings in. And because this one is not dry yet, the glue is not dry, I'll show you how my finished one came out. Here's the cocoon. Pull out. Here's our caterpillar with the wings. And you can unfold the wings, and there is your butterfly. And I'm going to put my butterfly back in the cocoon. So I'm going to wrap the wings around it and stick it right into its cocoon. We have one more really quick project I'm going to show you. So we've done a bee, we've done two butterflies and a caterpillar, and now I'm just going to show you, I'm not even going to demonstrate this because this is that easy. I have an ant. All I needed to use for the ant, I needed three circles, one, two, three, and I needed three pipe cleaners, and I cut out three circles. I drew a great big smile on with a white crayon. I put two googly eyes on. I glued the circles together. And then I'm going to take this one out. I'm going to show you what I did here, if I can get it out, because I kind of folded it. I put in a total of six holes in the middle circle so we could put the legs through. Because remember, all insects have how many legs? We have six. So we have one, two, three, four. And when we thread this one through, we now have six legs. All right, now, I'm very quickly going to get everything that we need for our snacks. We're just doing two snacks today. All right, I'll be right back. Now, the first snack that we're going to do today is a ladybug pizza. Now, for the ladybug pizza, all you need is an English muffin, tomato, slice of tomato, some black olives, some pesto, and of course, some mozzarella cheese. So the first thing we do is we spread about a tablespoon of pesto, I'm going to add a little bit more, onto the English muffin. We spread it around there a bit, and then we're going to top it with a slice of tomato, and I did cut out a little triangle at the back because the tomato will be the ladybug wings. And then, oh, I forgot something. You know what we had to put on? We had to put our cheese on. So then we put the pesto on. I'm going to add some mozzarella cheese. I do like a lot of cheese on my pizza. So we'll put our cheese on. Then we're going to put the slice of tomato on, and to decorate our ladybug, we're going to use some black olives that I have sliced. I'm just going to put some on the tomato there, and then we're going to put a whole olive. Now these have all been pitted, and then we're just going to put that on the front. That will be the ladybug's head. Then we bake it in the oven at 400 degrees for about 8 minutes. So that is our first snack. And this, I actually made one a little earlier. So let me show you what it looks like after it's baked. Pretty much the same. And there it is. There is our ladybug pizza. So that one I'll put in the oven in just a minute. Now, the next snack, which is very easy, I bet most of you have had ants on a log. That's with raisins, celery, and cream cheese. Well, today we're doing ants on a log, But we are not using celery and we're not using cream cheese. Instead, we are using red pepper, peanut butter, and raisins. So I'm just going to take some peanut butter and I'm going to spread it on a slice of a strip of the red pepper. I'll probably make two out of this because I put a lot of peanut butter on. All right, and here we go. And then we just have to put some raisins on for our ants. I have some here. So I'll just sprinkle some out of the box. And let's see. Let's see how many we get on this one. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we have 5 ants. And I'll put a little bit more peanut butter on this one. That way, in just a minute, I'm going to have a nice little snack. All right. That one. And we'll add just a couple of more raisins. And we have our ants on a log. All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed seeing some of the crafts you can make about insects. And I hope you liked seeing the snacks that you can make too. Ladybug pizzas and ants on a log. Until next time, everybody. Bye-bye.